My name is Kristin Knouse, and I'm an assistant professor in the MIT Department of Biology and Koch Institute for Cancer Research. One thing I've always felt about biology is that we should treasure our exceptions. And here the liver is providing us one of those incredibly informative exceptions. It is the only solid organ in our bodies that can completely regenerate itself. You or I could donate over 50% of our liver to someone in need. And in both us and the recipient, that remaining liver would completely regenerate to its original size in a matter of just 1 month. And I was struck by the fact that while we've known that the liver could regenerate for decades, even maybe hundreds of years, we still have no idea, no molecular explanation for why it is that the liver can regenerate while most other solid organs in our body cannot. So the fundamental question we're interested in is, why is it that a small subset of organs in our body can regenerate? And could we somehow leverage this knowledge to confer renewal ability to non-renewing tissues in the setting of injury or disease? So if you think about what's required to build a regenerative organ, it first requires that the organism somehow sense that the organ's been injured or compromised. And then you have to produce some sort of signal in response to that sensing that then can fall back on the injured organ and tell that organ to regenerate the missing part. And in the setting of liver cells called hepatocytes, we know a bit about that signal. We know that shortly after liver injury, there's a massive increase in the levels of hepatocyte growth factor. Growth factor, meaning that it's a molecule that can stimulate cells to proliferate and divide. This increases in the bloodstream shortly after liver injury, and it's both necessary and sufficient to drive the liver cells back into the cell cycle to regenerate the organ. However, we still have no idea how it is that the organism senses that the liver is injured to produce these huge amounts of hepatocyte growth factor. And we also don't know, why is it that when hepatocyte growth factor talks to a hepatocyte, it drives that cell to go back into the cell cycle, while when it talks to other cells, those cells cannot proliferate? And so you can see that these two fundamental steps of liver regeneration, both the sensing of injury and the production of a regenerative response, are poorly understood at the molecular level. So in the lab, we're really interested in tackling both of those questions, both ends of the regenerative problem. To understand how the organism senses liver injury, we're performing a lot of animal physiology experiments to really understand what's happening in those early hours after liver injury. We're trying to find cell types that we know are sensing liver injury and producing hepatocyte growth factor, and then working backwards to see, well, what is it that they're noticing that causes them to produce this growth factor? At the other end of the spectrum, to understand, well, why is it that these liver cells can proliferate while all other differentiated cells cannot, we're leveraging a technique we developed in which we can perform genome-wide screens in a living mouse liver so that we can identify all of the genes in the genome that are required for this unique and exceptional proliferative ability of the liver cells. So I really hope that we will be able to take this knowledge and apply it to human disease, to convince presently non-regenerative organs to renew themselves following injury. Human disease is really one of the greatest observational experiments of biology. It tells us all of the ways in which molecules and cells can go wrong. And I think there are still so many unanswered questions in human disease that underneath them have key principles of biology waiting to be uncovered. So my job is to foster an environment in which people feel confident and inspired to tackle those incredibly challenging but highly impactful questions. Questions that might easily be written off as too difficult or impossible. Because it's those questions, when met with persistence and confidence, that are the ones that really open up new advances for biology and medicine.